Okay, it's this morning is the 14th of March.
It's Pi Day.
314, it's Pi Day. So anyway, behind me is the Arch of St. Louis, St. Louis Arch. And then over here is the Hyatt, that's where we're staying. We're leaving there today, heading Route 66. And so we're just gonna hang out here a little while and then check them out, 10:25. We gotta check out by noon and then we'll head down Route 66 and see where we stop. Alright, now we're at the Eat Right Diner and we're still in St. Louis. Looks like a good place to get food poisoning, but we'll go see and attempt not to get food poisoning. You can see the arch just to get your perspective of where we're at. Well, we just finished at the Eat Right Diner and it was very good actually. And it was an old place, but they were very clean in their food preparation. The food was very good. Tasted much better than most, if any, fast food restaurant.
If you can't eat right, then don't eat at all.
That's their slogan. Can't eat right, don't eat at all. And there were two local guys in there that ordered 5 cheeseburgers each. And these are regular sized
cheeseburgers.
Oh, 6 cheeseburgers each. And she asked them if they wanted diet soda, and they kind of laughed, considering they had 6 cheeseburgers. But it was a nice place and nice older ladies running the place. So. This is Union Station, and it's like a train station, very similar to the Chattanooga Choo Choo in a lot of ways. And we're going to Hard Rock Cafe. Go ahead.
There's this one. Are you coming? Which do you think?
I like the one with the arch in it.
They all have the arch in it. Oh. You mean this one?
Yeah.
It's the guitar stick and the arch. I actually think this one's prettier. See, in this one, the saxophone music makes the arch. Better. See, that's the arch. This is the Hyatt.
Mm-hmm.
And this is like the riverboat. See that?
Yeah. That one's cool. Row, row, row your house gently down the street. Merrily, 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 merrily. Life isn't a dream. Okay, we're now turning into Ted Drew's. This is our next stop. And it's, is it custard?
Yeah, frozen custard, like concrete.
Oh, cool. So I'm going to eat some frozen custard and try not to retaste it because I'm pretty full. And I'm going to try not to wreck, so I'll talk to you all later.
What flavor do you want?
I don't know, but I want concrete.
I know.
Maybe some chip concrete.
What, do you want one too?
Yeah.
On top?
Yeah.
Concrete on top
is
like a
star. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
We're loving.
Yeah.
I want a regular punch on Sunday.
Well, it turns out that concrete tastes pretty good. This is from Ted Drew's since 1929. Still an old ice cream place, an old house, and very good for concrete. Even good for ice cream, which it technically isn't. It's
frozen custard.
Yeah, and it's good. Okay, I'm at the Museum of Transportation, and I guess by transportation we mean trains. They do have a DC-3 and tugboat and a bunch of trains, so we're going to go check this out.
Now. Is it internal combustion engines?
School bus in 1939 or a rail bus, but that's the year model.
I'm the door, you should fall down. Oh, that's a heavy door.
Oh, yeah.
HBO winning film Truman.
Museum sits on an active railroad out beyond that fence. That's the Union Pacific main line. They took this car, towed it to Kansas City, shot a couple of scenes, and brought it back.
That's cool. So they can, are any of those steam locomotives or any of those functioning? Do you know, work?
When we get off, you're going to see 1522, and I'll take you down and show her. She used to work all the time.
Oh, okay.
And I'll tell you more about it.
Actually nice traveling.
Yeah.
I did want to say that this car, the name of it is the Aleutian. It was built in 1927, and it's not typical of the period.
Oh, okay.
This is sort of like Bill Gates' private Learjet.
I was going to say, this is some nice traveling.
This
look
is
at
like
the shower.
This is a private office car.
Okay. See the shower?
Oh, wow. Yeah.
That
so that's not your typical coach
like,
traveling.
I didn't think you would get that nice of traveling, but hey.
All right, this is where Route 66 crosses the Merrimack River. The bridge is closed, so you have to take a different exit on the other side and to visit the actual 66 State Park that this road normally would go to. This is Route 66. The sign there says weight limit 5 tons, but underneath it says 60, and it's been crossed out, had a label put over it, and then they wrote a 5 on top of the 60. So I don't know if there was an accident or the bridge was re-rated or what the problem is, why it's closed. It does look like it's been redrawn and set up, so I'm not sure if this is a permanent closure or if they're preparing to reopen it for hikers and such at a later time. This is Route 66 right in front of us. This is also the Route 66 State Park that we just stopped at and driven around. It's a pretty nice park. Behind us is the Merrimack River, and the bridge is blocked off, so this is the beginning of the park.